Thank you, Madam Chair. Right, next is any standing reports or announcements? Tuesday, November 27th at 6:30 p.m. at Mary Buffett School. We're going to have a first district meeting. Mr. Olinger will be at the meeting, Director of Planning and Development Review. He will provide a look at proposed zoning changes for the Libby Road Patterson Avenue master plan that we'll talk about, also known as West Hampton. So again, I think it's going to be an important meeting for the citizens in the first district, and I look forward to seeing them again. That's Tuesday, November 27th at 6:30 p.m. Mary Buffett Hall. Thank you, Madam Vice President.
Thank you. This Thursday night, November the 15th, we're going to have our eight district meeting, and it starts at 6 o'clock, 8 o'clock. This Thursday night, November the 15th, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m., we're going to have our 8th District meeting at the Satellite, and everyone in 8th District is welcome to attend. Again, it's this Thursday, November the 15th, from 6 to 8 p.m. This one here is your free smoke alarm. At the Richmond Police Department, the Fire Department, they will come to your home, and they will install this smoke alarm for you for free. Smoke alarms save lives. They save your pets, and they save your home. If you call 646-1526, that's 646-1526, those firefighters will come to your home. They will install this. They won't leave it with you. They will install it. And also, they will check your other smoke alarms to see if you need batteries. If you need batteries, they will install the batteries. But it costs nothing. Right now, it's free. And we know last month, our President Barack Obama declared, October the 7th to the 15th, Fire Prevention Month, and he said that every citizen should have a working smoke alarm in their home. So let's take advantage of it while it's free. Because right now, it's the only thing that's free is the election. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Trammell. Pleasure you go.
Thank you, Madam President. I would just like to share that there will be a hosting of our second senior weatherization kit giveaway on Wednesday, November 14th at the East District Center located at 701 North 25th Street in Church Hill. This is being put on by the Department of Public Utilities, but the intent is to, again, provide our seniors with weatherization kits to be able to keep the homes a little more secure during this winter season. So again, second senior weatherization kit giveaway Wednesday, November 14th, located at 701 North 25th Street. And the time frame will be 9:30 to 2 p.m. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. I pass, Madam President.
You pass? Okay. Mr. Samuels? Oh, no. Yep. You already? Yeah. Mr. Robbins, you asked? No, I have one announcement. On the 22nd, I remember that they were doing it at the Amon Park, the Falls of IT's, and the 5:30 to 7:00. And the district meeting for the 6th district will be held on December the 8th at History Baptist Church from 10 to 12.
And is finance meeting this week?
Yes. Finance committee meeting is this week, Thursday at 3 o'clock. And I guess for the benefit of the discussion we had, there are several papers that are on the docket in regards to the development deal that we spoke earlier about. To Redskins coming to town. So I would encourage those that are interested in hearing that discussion in detail to make sure that they plan to attend the finance meeting on this week, Thursday. The meeting starts at 3 o'clock.
What time?
Mr.
where there would be all discussion on the Richmond plan. And how the new services is this room and decoration?
And public safety is next Monday.
I'm sorry.
Public safety is next Monday, Monday, this is about, yes, they are getting us all straight with paint. Okay, and I have just a couple of announcements. One of them is that all of the council people will be contacted. The administration is setting up budget meetings for various districts. So be on the lookout. Then I guess from the next meeting, everybody will know when it is and they can announce it. And we are also in the process of rescheduling the legislative session. And I want to thank everybody for hanging in. Particularly people who didn't have to be here, well, thank you very much for staying.
Yeah, President, thank you. I will not be able to attend my Madam Vice President meeting, Thursday meeting. But I just want to be, and I know you will, but just to make sure that we are vigilant in addressing the concerns that were raised by representatives from the very West Hampton community, that they have opportunity to have input in the financial state, you know, the preservation issues, those kinds of things that can otherwise devour our community. So, but anyway.
Yeah, and in addition to that, I'm hopeful that we just come with the timeline and the schedule we're looking forward to working with the support trying to get this legislation passed. I would also ask the representatives in regards to Leo Allen to all of the questions that they raised tonight, that they felt there were a discrepancy as relates to the master plan and the reform plan, to send all of those questions to the members of the Land Use Committee tomorrow so that we can have an opportunity to review those before the Land Use Committee. Can we ask Madam Vice President that the entire council receive that information as well? That's fine. I have questions, but I just want to be sure that all of this procedure is sure.
Thank you.
And your request, Ms. Newell, was ready yet?
Well, in regards to...
Why don't you send it to Lou? Lou can send it to you.
Yeah, in regards to the Riverfront, that all members receive, then the other Vice President had in terms of the Redskin paper.
All right, any other? All right, let's have the introduction of the new papers.
Introduction of the papers. Ordinance number 25-207 to authorize the CAO to accept funds from the United States Environmental Protection Agency for the purpose of forming a watershed coalition commitment. Finance and Economic Development, November 15th, Council Call King, November 26th. Office number 24-208, authorized Chief Administrative Officer to accept funds from the Virginia Department of Transportation for the purpose of funding the whole street road at Dover Road and Hago Highway Safety Improvement Program. Planning Commission, November 19th, Council Call King, November 26th. Ordinance number 2012-209 to amend city code by adding a new section for the purpose of declaring certain unsanitary and unsafe conditions to be nuisance and prohibited persons who own or occupy property for allowing such nuisance to exist. Education and Economic Development, November 28th, Council Public Hearing, December 10th. Ordinance number 28-210 to authorize the CAO to accept funds from the Institute of Museum and Library Services for the purpose of providing summer programs to reduce summer learning loss. Education and Human Services, November 28th, also called here, December 10th. Ordinance number 2012-211 to amend ordinance number 86-44-50. For the purpose of authorizing certain renovation to four-way stop signs and four-way flashing red lights at intersection of Lewis, Nessman Street, and Kingsland Avenue. Land use, November 20th, council public hearing is on 26. Ordinance number 2012-213, to accept a deed from the school board conveying 5600 Patterson Avenue to the city of Richmond. Planning commission, November 19th, council public hearing, November 26. Ordinance number 2012-214, to declare surplus and to direct the conveyance of 800 Patterson Avenue